just think about it. For 1,000 years in this neighborhood, people from Great Britain have lived and prospered. And we get to the 16th century when great drama occurs. Great drama. Henry VIII decides he's had enough with the Pope of Rome. He does not create a new church, but he creates a nation that is separate from the papacy. Separate. And thus the ancient English church, the ancient English kingdom, is separated from mainstream European ideology of the day. Mainstream European ideology, the development of the Roman Church under the Pope of Rome. His daughter, Queen Elizabeth I, sends a delegation, an embassy, to Constantinople, and we have the beginnings of an embassy, a trade delegation. Trade. The Levant Company is created. And, of course, an English chaplaincy. 1582. So we move through the 17th century up to the 19th century. And while Europe is terrified of the growth of the Ottoman Empire and the Turk, the English consolidate relations with the Ottoman Empire. So there is a great contradiction going on in European religion, ideology. The English, now liberated from the papacy, thrive in their relationship with the Turk. And as a result, come the 1840s, Queen Victoria has this magnificent Palladian palace built, designed on what is now the French embassy in Rome on the banks of the Tiber. But it is this building that came to signify the great growth of power in the British Empire. So here we have Stratford Canning, later Lord Stratford de Radcliffe. And Stratford Canning was one of the great British diplomats of the 19th century. Most of his diplomatic career was in Constantinople, where he befriended various sultans, but especially Sultan Abdul Mejid. And he is responsible for the Tanzimats, the reforms that took place in the 19th century in Turkey, and on which the basis of the modern republic was created. So we owe an awful lot to Stratford Canning. When he retired, he left Constantinople and was appointed to the House of Lords and took an active part in the upper chamber of Parliament for, I think, 2 decades afterwards. So here we have Charles Barry, reputed to be the architect of this great Palladian palace, and he certainly is revered here in Istanbul, and he graces the corridor en route to the grand ballroom where various sultans were received in great splendor, including Abdulmejid and Abdulaziz. So anyway, he has this honorable position in the corridor. So this grand ballroom was designed to be a reception room to receive the great and the good of Constantinople, patriarchs, emperors, and it certainly did that. Indeed, when the Sultan came to dinner here, it is believed to have been the first time an Ottoman emperor came to a Christian household where grace was said before eating. Christian prayer was offered before eating, and the chaplain of the day would have said grace. So this room has seen many things. It's unfortunate that it was burnt down, I think, on 2 occasions, and had to be restored, even in my town here in Istanbul. The thing I'd like to point out are the Waterford crystal chandeliers. They were being sent by Queen Victoria to the Tsar of all the Russias, and the Crimean War broke out in the 1850s, and Queen Victoria instructed that they should be left in the Grand Ballroom at Pera House in Constantinople. So they're slightly outsized for the dimensions of this room, but of course they make a great impression. So this is the chapel of the embassy to Constantinople, Her Britannic Majesty's Chapel, which is happily still here today. This current building, we've had a building here since the 17th century on this little plot of land, but this building was built in the late 19th century, and it was dedicated to Saint Helena. St. Helena, you see in the window. Unfortunately, the window had to be restored after a bombing a few years ago. But St. Helena looks like a young Queen Victoria. And of course, St. Helena was the mother of Constantine, the builder of the city, the creator of Byzantium as we came to know it. And of course, the city was ennobled with his name. Constantinople, the city of Constantine. And here the consulate general, successor of the embassy mission that was here, still has its worship. There's still a chaplain. Although we exist as independent voices, we still have a chaplaincy established here in Istanbul, Turkey.